We don't know yet. We'll have to wait and see the polls, but I'll tell you what it did do is change the dynamics of this campaign. As much as we can argue about who won last night, there is no question that Hillary Clinton's team has taken control of this campaign today. This has been he had a bad night last night. He's had a terrible day after. I just want to read you what on a New York Times lead website tonight, after saying that, what he did early this morning, attacked the moderator, said his microphones are not working, attacked Miss Venezuela. Headlines: shamed and angry, Alyssa Machado, a Miss Universe mocked by Donald Trump. Suburban women find little to like in Donald Trump's debate performance. What Donald Trump got wrong on stop and frisk. The reverse gaslighting of Donald Trump. I grant you, Jeff, that they've hardly been appreciative of Donald Trump in recent weeks. But still, this has been a terrible day. It's a terrible day.
And what is your response, Jeff? Because you can spin it either way, but he has been out this today sounding very defensive.
Let me talk about the Miss Universe contestant. I'm reading now from the London Daily Mail, and if I may return paragraph for paragraph. But now two Associated Press reports from 1998 have revealed that Machado was accused of aiding attempted murder and threats to kill in Venezuela. The DailyMail.com has asked the Clinton campaign whether they knew about the accusations, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So in other words, her credibility is now under attack. What specifically, I want to say this.
I will just simply point out for the record, none of that is confirmed anything by CNN, just because I need to do that. Okay. I'm just pointing that out. But go ahead, finish your point.
I understand. Okay. My point is that the whatever he called her there, Miss Piggy, is hearsay, yes?
He has not denied.
Let me finish my point. Yeah. So if we're going to deal in that kind of hearsay, I would hope and I suspect that the Trump campaign would be on the ball with this Gary Byrne, the Secret Service agent, who wrote this book, Crisis of Character, and has chapter and verse in there about Hillary Clinton's temperament and her conduct as First Lady. In other words, sauce for the goose is going to be sauce for the gander here.
But seriously, hearsay aside, the fact of the matter is that Donald Trump last night, first impressions matter.
He has, by the way, landed in Florida, bad weather, but he is there and he's going to be speaking momentarily. We are going to listen to him. We listened to Hillary Clinton earlier, but we'll see when he gets off that plane. Okay. Go ahead, Basil.
So first impressions matter, and for the number of people that saw last night, I don't know how many will see the second debate, but the fact of the matter is he looked like he didn't know what he was talking about. He looked unprepared. He looked unknowledgeable about public policy and how government works. And that's a problem when you're running for president of the United States. She was prepared. She spoke to the American people and had specific policy prescriptions for how she would move people to the middle class. She was presidential last night, and that matters.
So Dana, what is the Trump campaign? You've got sources who are telling you about what they are thinking right now, what their plans are. What are you hearing?
Yeah, I was going to say, certainly there are a lot of things to discuss that are specific moments and the aftermath and, mm-hmm. and the aftershocks about last night. But I think the most telling are the conversations that you have privately with people who really, really liked Donald Trump and wanted him to do well. And that is that they were incredibly disappointed. Some were frustrated because, yes, he did not have the formal training that and sort of the debate camp that Hillary Clinton had with the mock debates and somebody playing her.
Right.
But he was prepared. I mean, he was preparing and he was given, sort of clean, simple talking points for some of the big issues. They went over pivots. Which apparently I'm told he does not like that term, but it's the way to get away from when Hillary Clinton is going after you to move to something that is more on offense towards her, and so the frustration is really palpable. The hope, I talked to one person I think who put it beautifully, is that Donald Trump is the kind of person you can't say don't touch that stove, it's hot. You have to wait until he actually touches the stove and says, oh, it's really hot, until he says, oh, I won't do it again.
So now
meaning they're hoping he's going to change.
We have to go back to the disagreement between David and Jeffrey, who are good friends of ours, okay? Putting aside what Jeffrey said is she's accused of, that has nothing to do with Donald Trump saying that she was Miss Piggy and then doubling down this morning on Fox News and saying, oh, she got really fat, she got overweight. That has nothing to do with that.
And to that point, Jeff, isn't that an implicit admission that he said Miss Piggy? He didn't say, I didn't say it. He came out the next morning and said she did get fat.
Two things.
She was a problem.
Two things. Number one, whatever her contract, I mean, people in lives have contracts for all sorts of things. You're supposed to do what the contract is. If she were in violation of her contract, by putting on weight. I don't know if that's the case, but if that is the case, then that's a contract violation. But the larger point I want to make here is...
Wait.
The important thing here is the audience out there, not us and folks like us and all of our friends that we know all over the place in Washington, D.C. and elsewhere, but people in their living rooms watching this, the people who are thinking about the country. And for those people, I'm thinking that he scored a hit when he talked to her and addressed her as a politician who basically comes out. I mean, all the things that we think are an asset. She was poised. She was this. She was that. There are a lot of people out there that are saying she's just more of the same and this is the problem.
Maeve.
But I don't think, I mean, I just found Donald Trump's strategy of doubling down, as Mark said, totally baffling this morning. I mean, he was, for him to not see that that has been the kinds of behavior that has gotten him in trouble over and over again throughout the campaign and try to pivot away from it is just shows you sort of how stuck in his ways he is. And no matter what his advisors ask him to do, he just can't restrain himself. And by the way, I mean, a lot of those comments about Machado are on tape. So people can just look at the tape and they're going to judge for themselves.
All right. Well, let's just hit pause for a moment. You're all going to be with me because obviously we're waiting for Donald Trump to get off that plane. He's going to be speaking, first rally since last night. Going to talk about the debate. And next, that and, of course, Trump and Clinton and their words coming back to haunt them. Plus, did Clinton bait Trump into admitting he didn't pay federal taxes or not? And the debate was nothing to sniff at, or was it?
We wish you a lot of luck. You're wrong. Mexico said, okay, good.